Family.
Good morning.
First, I give honor to God, my heavenly Father,
yes,
the great architect of the universe.
Yes, yes, yes.
And then I honor the elder brother, my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Reverend Evie,
bless you.
Head shepherd here of greater faith.
Yes.
Honor and respect, man of God.
Amen. Bless you.
Brother King.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
We respect you, first ladies.
Amen. Bless you, bless you.
Bless you.
Shamika.
Bless you.
Mother Green, it's definitely good to see you this morning.
Amen.
Yes.
Now, I'm going to reiterate what Pastor Edie said. I'm going to ask that you all pray with me and for me this morning.
Yes.
As I attempt to share with you a few thoughts.
All right.
Now,
lesson, Lord. Lesson.
I was glad when they said unto me,
yes, yes, Lord.
There is a word from God.
Uh-huh.
Now,
right.
Turn with me, if you would, to the book of St. Luke,
all right.
The 16th chapter.
Mm-hmm.
Verses 27 and 28. That's the 16th chapter of the book of St. Luke, verse 27 and 28.
Amen.
Now, we're going to be coming in during the middle of a parable, but let us not worry about that right now. I'm going to try to tie all this together and make it make sense.
Bless you, Lord.
Bless you. Now, that's Luke 16,
mm-hmm,
27 through 28.
Amen.
Yeah?
Amen. Amen.
Okay. And the word of God reads, then he said, I pray thee therefore, Father,
mm-hmm,
that thou wouldest send him to my father's house.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And then in 28, for I have five brethren,
mm-hmm,
that he may testify unto them,
mm-hmm,
lest they come into this place of torment.
Oh my God.
May God always add a very special blessing to the reading and doers of his holy word.
Amen.
While you all still standing, or if you're able, please stand with me as we go to the Lord in prayer. Oh, good and gracious Heavenly Father.
Yes, Lord.
Great architect of the universe.
Bless him, Lord.
My
bless
Lord and Savior.
Yes, Lord.
Come now, your humble servant, with a bowed head and an humble heart.
Yes, Lord.
Father,
yes,
as humbly as I know how.
Oh, God.
Father, I come
bless
before
now
your throne this morning just to say thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Father, thank you for the great many blessings you've already bestowed upon us.
Yes, Lord.
Father, thank you for your grace and mercy.
Thank you.
Father, I thank you that you love me so much, mm-hmm, that you gave your only son as a sacrifice.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Father, I thank you for all those bowed down here under the sounds of my weak voice. Father, I thank you for the privilege to serve as your messenger.
Oh, yes.
Father, use me as you will.
Please, Lord.
And Father, I pray as did the psalmist David when he wrote in your holy word, may these words of my mouth,
yes,
the meditation of my heart, be pleasing in your sight,
oh, yes,
my rock and my redeemer.
Yes, Lord.
So more to thee. Amen.
Amen.
Y'all go ahead and take your seats now.
Right.
We need to read from the gospel as recorded by Luke in the New Testament.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let me point out that Luke was recording the words of Jesus,
mm-hmm,
as he told a parable. In verse 28 is where we will find the center for my speaking to you this morning. And if you'll allow me a little creative license here, I'm going to use for a topic this morning, hell ain't no place for a family reunion.
What? Say that again, say that again.
There ain't no place for a family reunion.
Hell is no place for a family reunion.
This story, terrible as it is, it's the story of a rich man, an unnamed rich man, and a beggar named Lazarus.
Yes, yes.
All right.
Now,
bless him, Lord. Bless him.
die.
All right.
The beggar went to Abraham's bosom. And Lazarus wound up in hell. Now, I need to stop and point this out and make it
all right, clear. All right.
That hell is a very real place.
Amen.
All right.
And
right.
So is heaven.
Amen.
In fact, in my Bible, hell appears 54 times.
Uh-huh.
Right.
But heaven, some 622 times.
Okay.
Right.
And there are scriptures about heaven in 54 of the 66 books of the Bible.
Mm-hmm. All right.
I'm saying I like the way that it sounds a lot better.
All right.
Now,
take your time.
The rich man died and went to hell.
That's right.
Lazarus went to heaven.
Okay.
All right.
Now, I need you to bear with me for just a few moments.
All right.
I'm going to tie this together. I promise. It'll make it make sense. Okay. Now,
Use it.
That's it. First of all, I'm not going to stand up here and try to pretend I'm all perfect and all of that.
That's all right.
Come on, husband.
I declare to the Romans that no one is righteous, no, not one.
Amen.
And comes short of the glory of God.
Okay.
But here's the thing.
Talk to me.
Once you know better,
that's it.
You gotta do better.
You are expected to do better.
Amen.
Amen.
Let me say that again. Once you know better,
that's right.
You are expected to do better.
Amen. Can I get a witness?
As the story goes, okay, let's take a look at this for just a minute. All right. The rich man who was dressed in purple and fine linen, who was laid at, he was in luxury every day.
Yes, he was.
And at the gate was laid this beggar named Lazarus, covered with sores, wanting to eat what fell from the rich man's table.
Yes. All right.
Yes. Even the dogs came and licked his sores. The time came when the beggar died and angels carried him to Abraham's side.
Yeah.
All right. The rich man also died and was buried.
Amen.
In hell, he was in torment and looked up and saw Abraham.
Yes. Yes. Uh-huh.
He's dead. He in hell. Abraham in heaven.
No.
And he looked.
No.
He had pretty good vision. It had to at least be 20/20.
Yeah.
So this thing was done as a land and Cadillac, that ain't happening.
All right.
Now, my Bible tells
that
me that they had a conversation.
Uh-huh.
He was talking to Abraham afar off, and Abraham responded back to him. So his ears was working.
That's right.
His mouth was working.
That's right.
His eyes was working.
That's right.
He could definitely feel, because when he goes on down, he says, I beg you, Father, that you send Lazarus.
Come on,
wait a minute. Before he got there, he asked him to dip his finger in the water and cool his tongue.
Yeah. That's what he said.
Hell is a very real place.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Now, let me get back on track here.
Take your time.
Come on, minister.
Okay. Now, I need you to understand that when this life ends, there is going to be another life.
Say it.
There is going to be a life after this.
Say it.
And we need to start to prepare ourselves for that life.
Yes.
All right. The problem comes in with the way we want to live our life today.
That's right.
We want to do that sin, repent, and sin again thing. And then we want to play these little words down.
Ouch.
Now, I was reading the other day where it said, how many times can you be forgiven?
70 times 7.
Forgiven 7 times 7 in one day.
One day.
That's what the said.
Now, I'm thinking to myself.
Who gonna send him a?
70 times 7, you know the math, that's 490.
That's what it is, husband. That's what it is.
How much messing up do you plan on doing in one day?
I know.
No, I'm just saying.
That's all.
How much messing up do you plan on doing in one day?
Exactly.
And be forgiven for this and still call yourself Christian?
Say that.
If that's the case, heaven will be full of food.
Oh, man.
I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Say the right thing.
Forgiven,
But we're going to sin and repent and sin again and hope that when God comes back, we're not caught up.
My God. Think about it.
On the sin side. That's a 50-50 chance. I don't like those odds, especially when it comes to my salvation.
Yeah.
Hell is a very high price to pay.
Yes.
50-50 our odds.
All right.
Okay. But we ain't got to worry about all that. Uh-huh. So we're Christian, but we know God's forgiveness is in it. We can talk that all our lives. All you got to do is just say, I'm sorry, turn away, don't do that no more.
And mean it.
Okay. God's forgiveness is unlimited.
Oh, my God.
Preach.
Well, the preacher told me the other day that hell wasn't built for no reason. Oh my God. You think God was just sitting up there bored and just make it.
Say that then.
To do with my time.
Can I get a witness?
He made it for a reason.
Amen.
Now, I'm not going to be up here long. I'm going to go.
Take your time, husband.
Right. Okay. Now, just before, I want to just. I can't help but beg the question, what's going to happen when God comes back and I am not ready?
Oh, my God. Oh, my Lord.
I really
think about it.
Really hope.
That's scary.
It's scary. Come on, you are.
I hope I'm on the other side of this thing.
All right.
But now, I got to thinking, it's like, okay, God's going to forgive us because he loved us so much. And he's just going to keep on forgiving us and keep on forgiving
us. Oh, my God.
And then, I did what Pastor Edie said. He said, pray, and then do what God told you to do. Well, I prayed, and I said, God, I need you to help me to speak this thing. And he directed me to the book of Hebrews.
All right.
And I was reading it, and I read it to my wife. I said, baby, well, what do you think? Well, we went to the book of Hebrews, the 10th chapter, verses 26. Through 27. Now, I did not write this Bible. I just read it.
All right.
But looking there, I found these words. If we deliberately keep on sinning, after we have received the knowledge of the truth, no sacrifice for sins is left.
There's
only a fearful expectation of judgment and a raging fire that will consume the enemies of God. Now, Jerry didn't say that.
That's it.
You need to take that up with Paul. Okay. Now, I pointed out earlier that nobody's perfect.
You right.
Right. Yeah.
But what me and Paul is talking about here is willful misconduct. Like I said, when you know better,
you got to do better.
Amen.
Okay. Now, the real message that I have for you this morning is the trip from the womb to the tomb is not very far.
Oh, God.
In fact, Job said,
all right,
a man who is born of a woman is a few days.
All right.
Okay. And you're going to die.
Now,
that's backed up in 2 Corinthians 5 and 1.
Uh-huh.
We know that when this earthly tent we live in is taken down, that's when we die and leave this earthly body.
That's right.
We're going to have a brand new home.
Oh, God.
Okay. Now, the psalmist records in chapter 49, 7 through 9,
redeem the life of another.
Uh-huh.
A gift to God, a ransom for it.
Right.
The ransom for life is costly.
Yes.
No payment is ever enough.
That's right.
So that they should live on forever and not see pay.
Oh, Jesus.
Now, nobody can do this for you.
That's right.
There's not something mama can do. Something your father can do. Your wife, your mother, your brother. It does not matter what kind of car you drive or house you live in.
All right, all right.
None of that's going to matter. You don't need red bottom shoes to walk around in. Stacey Adams is not a prerequisite. It's about your heart. It's about what's going on in your heart.
Yes.
Now, my bishop back home used to say that it's not really always about your heart, it's about what you do. It's about what you do that other end. Prepare lips or anything.
Uh-huh.
But then it's about what you're doing day to day.
Yes.
Right. Now, I'm going to try to go and close this up. Now, I strive to be like Paul every day.
Ooh,
when you go to 1 Corinthians 2:2-3, for I resolved to know nothing while I was with you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. Jerry does not have a heaven and hell.
Come on,
Jerry
yeah.
Cannot save you.
Mm-hmm.
Only Jesus Christ.
Yes,
now, I'm just a messenger of the kingdom, an humble servant, and I'm just trying to get home.
Amen.
And the only way I know is through a man named Jesus.
Right.
Yes,
now,
yes.
The old song says, "I'm just a nobody
trying to tell somebody
about anything.
Somebody
who can save
you." Yeah.
In Christ Jesus, you don't have to worry if you stumble and fall. Mm. You're going to be talked about.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
you're
going
to be mistreated.
Yes.
You're going to be lied on.
Yes.
You're going to be cheated.
Oh,
it's
God.
It's going to be dark in your life. Family and friends going to turn their back on you.
Yes.
That's okay.
Uh-huh.
He said, "I'm going to prepare a place for you."
That's what he said.
Yes.
There, you may be also.
Yes, Lord.
He said that when this old tent is turned out,
uh-huh,
that I'm going to have a new home.
One
not made by
man's hands.
Real briefly, I want to look back at the things that I said.
Mm-hmm.
One, hell definitely is no place for family reunion.
Amen. You got a witness.
I live a little while. You notice on those tombstones that have the year you were born.
That's right.
A little dash.
A baby dash.
You got to be careful what you're trying to place on that day.
All right.
It's not a lot of space.
No.
So you can't get up, you can't be all mouthy.
Can't be ready.
You need to go to the point.
Uh-huh.
That's right.
You're going to live a little while.
Uh-huh.
And I like to say, I'm trying to earn my ticket.
All right.
I'm trying to get home.
Yeah.
Now, you can call it what you want.
All right. But
as a young man, I had an opportunity to be traveling. And I really enjoyed it. I got to see the world. I left home a rich book. And as I grew up, I got to thinking about God and the inevitable and all of these different gods. So I got to go to China, and it was amazing.
I got
off the plane, and like they sucked all the air out of the plane. It was hot. Stank. Drove on the wrong side of the road. They ate with sticks. I read the Buddha's grave.
Uh-huh.
And it says here, now it's Buddha.
Yeah. But that's what Buddha lied.
Got to go to Israel and Muhammad's plaque pretty much said the same thing.
Oh,
that's not mine.
All right.
And it says this was the grave of Jesus.
Was.
And you go inside and have the slab inside.
And you go inside, and I looked at it, wasn't nobody there. And I went back outside, and I looked, and the door was open.
Preacher's name.
But he was not in it. Figured I'd get in behind a living God. So, back to that little dash. There's not a lot of time. Job said a few days. We did a few days. So it's going to become real, real important what you put on that dash. It's not quantity.
Think about it.
It's not quantity. It's quality. It's the quality. God has said, do this, do this, and definitely do not do this, do this. You got some rules.
Amen.
Lazarus, the rich man, went to hell for what? I was reading and I didn't see where he committed murder. He didn't rob, steal.
Come on. Think about it.
Then I got to thinking, Jerry, what were you doing yesterday morning? He didn't do. You can't say amen and God say amen. I'm thinking about the way I live. He basically, Deacon told me about that a couple weeks ago. He said it's a sin on me. Now what about all the lying you're doing? What about all this stuff written over here on the wall? All right, these church folk. What about these all this stuff written over here on the wall that you need to be doing? And then how you gonna be tripping with your brother or your sister up in God's house? Why don't they get along in heaven like this? I'm just saying.
Somebody ain't gonna.
We got work to do.
Amen.
We got work to do.
Amen.
Start with Jerry. So I'm gonna, I'm just gonna point these three niggas back here at me. Start with Jerry. I got work to do.
Yes.
To do.
Ain't got time.
So do you.
Amen. All of us. You got a witness.
We got work to do.
So now that we know, come on, we know better. It's time to start doing better.
Amen.
It's not built.
Yes.
For no reason.
Amen.
He built heaven so that we would have a home.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Hell was not built